say humbling is our praise due to Allah. Because all of you who see us here, you say, well, who's that little short, fat, bald-headed man? What could he have done? Why are they talking about this man like that? It's not because of me, because I don't even know why myself. All I know is one day in Detroit, I was just fooling around, really fooling around. And I run into a man, and he began to tell me about Elijah Muhammad. And I listened, you know? I said, oh man, this man's too cocky, bitch. And I went back over there the next day and he started talking. And I found myself going over there every day. And I decided that I was going to help this man who I've never seen before. Because what they were saying about him was next to my heart. And that's why that I come east with Malcolm. Malcolm didn't send for me. I come here to him from Detroit. Because he was in Boston and he had a man up there and he couldn't do the job. So he called me up one day. He said, man can't do the job. I said, well, why would you? I said, you know, I told you I would come out there and help you, but I don't want to come out there to be no captain. I'm not no captain. He said, you come anyway. You just do what I tell you to do it and we'll take care of the rest. And that's how I got to the East Coast. And then you know the rest of the history. So I would like to say that, as Mr. Muhammad wrote, history of all I studied is most attractive and best qualified to reward our research as it develops the strains and motives of human action and displays its consequences of circumstances which operates most powerfully on the destiny of the human being. Now for 15 years, almost 20 years, we've been dealing in Bali. We have done everything that we thought we wanted to do. We have said everything that we thought we wanted to say. And we have heard everything that we thought we wanted to hear. But now I hear a yearning from across the country that we must put this thing back together some kind of way. It is necessary. I'm running up low. Two more words. Myself, I could not get anywhere without Allah and the guidance of Elijah Muhammad. That's who made me. And I met Sylvia, my wife, with all three. And I'm trying to do the very best I can. I took care of my responsibility. And that's the first duty of a man, to take care of his family. Remember that a family consists of this, a male and a female coming together, carrying on human reproduction that brings about a child. That's a family. No two males or no two females make a family. That's the only way you can have a family is a male and a female coming together and making one. That makes a family. Now, it's not an accident that the Creator said that mankind is but one family. And this is what it's all about. It is all about family. And we are a family. We have been bound here. We have been bound here. No one else come to our aid. No one else taught us. No one else come and bought us this. How do you think we can get up here and say these things that we're saying? You got to ask the question, who told these people these things? How did they know this? Who talked to them? It was because a man by the name of Elijah Muhammad who heard a man who said he come from the east. Captain Silk, he was the one that whispered in his ear. Then he left. After 3 years, and then this one, Elijah Muhammad, stayed here for the rest until he passed in 1977 and did not get shot down because he had men that would lay at his feet, who had men that would take their bodies and shield. He never made any bones that he didn't. He always stood up to whatever, took care of his business. You see? And then you can't say anything about him, but you read the papers today, brother, and you'll find out, I mean, they're just crazy now. So history, of all our studies, is most attractive and best qualified to reward our research. And we must deal in history. We can't code up history. We can't have it the way we want it to be. That's why they call it history.
Right.
It is the facts. Only the facts. And that's all we deal in. Just the facts. Nothing else. We don't want any misconstructions. Do not take on misconstructions other than our time. The labor must be prevented from pronunciation of words and syllables in the proper tense. Otherwise, it will not be accepted. That's why the scholars are here. Because we want you to know, we want you to know that we're just but no 90-day wonder people. We are the people. And then our children are here. I think I'll offer my wife.
Yes, sir.
There she is over there. Met her when she was 19 years old. Right. In Philadelphia. When I met her, she was doing research for Malcolm. She go do the research in the library, and he would get up there and teach me. That's right. And she has been with me, and I have three children. Three boys and three girls, and a host of grandchildren. So I say all praise is due to Allah. So I don't want to deviate, and I want to take up any more time. But I want to say to you, prayer has been established. Come on now. Prayer has been established. Now what? All right now. The Holy Quran says, establish prayer and pay the poor rate. Now, if we're going to pay the poor rate, oh, and we'll break it down more clearly to you, give you charity. Find some money in here. That's what it means when it says pay the poor rate. A tax. All religions preach that. Prayer has been established. Now what? You must establish prayer and pay the poor rate. And the problem today is that we must get our people to stop being consumers. And we must show them how to make jobs for themselves. And those of you who are scholars, who have this education and this knowledge, I'll say the brother from Africa, when he comes to ask you what he's going to do, I'm going to get my education, I'm going back home, and I'm going to live some time over there. South America, he'll tell you the same thing. Central America, Asia, they will tell you the same thing. And I say to you here, Allah has blessed you to have an abundance of education. Now, how much time are you going to give for the cause of truth? I won't even say Islam. For the cause of truth. Because we are not as big. We are not as important as our people. I told Mr. Falcon that 2 weeks ago. I said, the rise of our people is more important than you and I could have been. He agreed with me. He said, yes, that's right. I said, so what are we going to do about it? It might be necessary that we take a second tour of duty. You've get together and we do this. So I'm going to love the Lord because we got to get out of here. Because Mr. Muhammad said you must recognize that. Time is money. Time is life. And we must be on time. We must start on time and we must finish on time.
Right.
This is Friday night. We got other places we got to go. That's right. We have other things we have to do. I want to say this to you, though. That the words that the president, Mr. Muhammad, was taught by, here's what he said. He said, I can stand on top of the world. I can stand on top of the world and tell anyone that the most beautiful nation is in the wilderness of North America.
That's right.
Then he directed his attention to the women. He said, but do not let me catch any subject being other than stuff in regards to living life and wearing property.
Right.
Now, Mr. Muhammad come back and said, the elevation, the protection, and the control of the black women is essential. Then the president said in his final statement, he said, big deal to waste the wide awake man to work out. Arise the dead nation by the thousands, for the dead nation must arise. He said, look in your boys' book. He didn't say you had to study it. He didn't say, just look in there. The boys' book is what they refer to as the Bible. He said, look in your boys' book. And the reason he said it was poison, he said, there's some truth in there, and there's some poison in there. He didn't condemn it, he just said, stated what it was. You are the righteous, the best, and the powerful. And that's a statement, brother, that carried me on. And I would like to say to Brother Tariq, I knew his father, Edward 15. And I want to let you know, those of you who are here, that was my heart for. That's why you didn't know my business. Hussein Shabazz. Great Hussein Shabazz. Usman Shah. And Thomas 15. That was my goal. That's why you were a great student. That's why you didn't know what to do. Because that was the call. Mr. Muhammad said that Islam is circles. And you're dealing in circles. Is that understood? And so therefore, we say all praise is due to Allah. So we knew that we were honeycombed and with spies and what have you. But that didn't make us no difference because we had the right people. And I say that if we get together and you know who the leaders are, you know who they are. And we ain't championing anyone's cause. All